is that there has been an allegation that why was I asking for an administrative report? How else would I know the details of what was going on? You can only know through an administrative report. The administrative report is the one that comes from inside the institution to a cabinet minister saying this is why we have suspended the CEO. We suspect that they have done this transaction. This is what the, and by the way, I started by talking about the role of the board. Those issues also have to go through the board before they come to the minister. The minister doesn't get direct briefings on certain issues where there's already a mandated legal requirement by a board to provide the oversight. So whether it is exciting or not, the point of the matter is at that point, I did not know. And I didn't know until I left, for the simple reason I never left when I had received an administrative report. And I requested for the administrative report. That's all you can do as a minister. If I went beyond that, you would now be accusing me of interfering with investigations. You'd be saying, why am I asking when EACC has been told to investigate and CID has been asked to investigate? So let's be clear on which side we are leaning on. What is it that I failed as a minister to do? I asked for an administrative report. It did not come. Why? Because I asked for it on the day when they wrote to EACC, which was 4th November. I resigned on 21st of November. So if it was like 6-7 months, that's another conversation altogether. But maybe they were already preparing it. Who knows? But in terms of being provided for a briefing, I would never make reference as a minister to a verbal briefing. That's not the way the way government works. That's on the issue of the briefing and what did I do. So did I do what needed to be done? Yes. Ask for the administrative report in addition to the EACC and CID report when they are ready. Those are not institutions that are subject to individual ministries. So once you have called in CID and called in EACC, wait for their reports to come. There's nothing else a minister can do beyond that. Now, the second issue...
Relax, members. Let her respond to the question that you're going to ask. Please.
The second question is that the PS confirmed he gave me a brief. Where is the brief? Where is the brief he gave me? I don't know. He needs to provide the brief. Maybe just like the letters that came, there is no briefing I received on this matter from the PS in writing. And as a minister, you receive briefs in writing, just the same way they've written this letter. You received this, that brief was not forthcoming. Maybe it was still being prepared by the board, I do not know. But to the best of my recollection, I never received any briefing whatsoever from the PS.